Language Awareness and L1. Now, let us see what is the role of L1 allocated by the language awareness pedagogical theory. So, LA or language awareness argues that the use of L1 or the first language of the learners empowers the learners to consolidate and systemize the knowledge of the second language. So it is an important tool of mediation. It does not use the word of mediation, but definitely what it is saying is almost similar. LA also argues that with the use of L1, the learners become conscious of the relationship between different languages. They now think of language as a tool of doing things, and they try to understand how to manipulate the language to do the same things but in different ways because of the use of different languages. So, what is the aim of L1 in LA pedagogy? Language awareness argues that the aim of the L1 use is to lead or to guide the learners towards enhanced communicative competence in both languages. They argue that if the learners see how language actually works within society, it will improve their use of language. It will improve or enhance their communicative competence in not just L2 or the second language, but it will also improve their use of language, that is their first language. Now, what do we mean by communicative competence? Please remember that by communicative competence, we don't mean fluency only. We don't mean accuracy of the use of language only. We mean how enabled a learner is to manipulate a language, to say or to use a language in a way that expresses the needs of the learners, in a way that it actually does for him or her what they want to achieve through language. That is communicative competence. How accurately, how fluently, but yet how much meaningful is their communication? And then the question is, how can L1 do all these tasks? It argues that L1 or the first language of the learners can help the learners because it allows the learners explicitly, that is, on the surface, clearly, manifestly, to develop cross-cultural links between the two languages. We argued in the inner, when we were talking about the inner speech and when we were talking about the socio-cultural theory of learning, which definitely talks about the internal processes of learning and how important the role of L1 or the first language of the learner was from them for the learners. Over here, when we talk about pedagogy or teaching practices, they are not implicit, they are explicit. They are out there to be observed. So when we use language or the first language in the classrooms, we allow our learners to make comparisons, to develop relationships, or to say something, actually talk about the kinds of links they can make between the two languages or the three languages. Maybe the learner knows more than one language. Now, this emphasis of the first language in L2 or in second language learning is emphasized on certain bases. What are those bases? That we will discuss in the coming module.